Welcome to Car Questions. Do you have a Dodge Ram and the power door locks aren't working? Well, the front one on this one is, but the back one isn't. Well, I'm going to show you what the cause is and how to fix it. The problem is right in this loom most of the time, and that's for anything from a Dodge to a Ford, Chevy, Land Rover, you name it. Anybody that has these flexible connections to the power in the door for speakers, power door locks, power windows, the wires break in here. They're just simply a bunch of wires. And this is the most common problem. Do not waste your time checking a lot of other things. Always check this. Check it first, because you're going to find broken wires in there. So pull that back as far as you can and look very carefully inside here for broken wires. Even pinch them with your finger just to see if they're coming apart inside. Sometimes they do that too, but this is the problem for the power door locks and windows and speakers, etc., on Dodges and Chevys and all kinds of cars. First step, get yourself a Phillips screwdriver. That's the star one. Right there is a bolt. Pull the handle back and take out this one bolt with your Phillips screwdriver and put it in a safe place close by. Next, get yourself a quarter midget drive ratchet and a 10 millimeter socket. Okay? You might want to use 3/8, whatever you've got, 10 mil socket. Right in here, there's a 10 mil bolt that holds door handle off. You've got to get that off. So set the ratchet to remove, and should be able to feel around for it a bit. And again, take the bolt, put it in a safe place, close by, with the handle. Somewhere it won't get lost, stepped on or busted. A long bolt, and there we go. That's what it looks like. Got the bolt, no need to take it right out, looks like it stays in there, and you're good. Once you got the handle off, this door panel doesn't come off the typical way where you just pull on it and there's a bunch of snaps. It actually has to just be forced up. So give it a good shot, like that, and off it comes. Before you take the panel right off and disconnect the switch here, power the window up out of your way if it's in the down position. You'll need the key on to do that, and then you can turn the key off. Then you can proceed to take off that door panel. Well, it looks like the speaker is not attached to the door, which is a great thing. So all you have is the one switch here. Little button on top, give it a little bit of a yank, off it comes. And then just take the door panel and put it somewhere safe. So here we are on the left rear door of this Dodge Ram. I've already taken off the door panel, as you can see. And I've pulled back the rubber cover, the loom between the door and the door frame, and popped the connector out here. And you can see right away, you can see two broken wires right there. Nice. So anyway, what I'm going to do now is show you how to repair this. Now the whole idea is going to be is to disconnect this connector over here, and we pull it out. You're going to fiddle with it to get it out. Push on a little pin like normal and pull on it, tug it till it comes off like that. Then let's pull back the vapor barrier. You've got to remove the speaker, and it's three screws and it's a Phillips screwdriver, and that's about all the room you need. And there's a little pin right here that holds the loom, so take a small pair of pliers and work on that pin until you can get it in like that and pop it out like that. And another one right here. Push, take the pliers and or anything, whatever you got, and push it in there, because we have to get the loom out to work on it. It's easier to work on it I'm gonna pull it through here to work on it. So, and I got the rubber grommet right there. Maybe get a screwdriver, start pushing it in. That seems to work well. Just using a regular screwdriver here. And there she goes. Hopefully this end will fit in it. Fiddle with it, of course, always. Always, always, always. Speaker wire out of there. Speaker connection. And there we go. Now that you have it here, it's just a lot easier to work on and a lot easier to inspect. So we shove this down a bit. Maybe we can get some room to work on these wires. Because that's all I'm looking for. You can see the two wires that are broken right there. Anyway, now all you have to do is solder the two connections together, get the wires. You got some room here to work. Use a bullet connector, some guys do, I don't recommend it, but solder it together and then reinstall it. Once I've pulled back the loom and picked out the wires from inside there, because they can get tangled, I've got one, I've got two, I have three, I have four broken wires. It's amazing, because the power window on this thing worked and everything. And I've got another one on the way. You can see that one's gonna break right there. It's not broken yet. And this one here, this little guy, it's split. It's gonna go too. So, unbelievable amount of damage in these Dodge trucks. But anyway, all that's left to do now is repair this and get it back in service. So here we go. Got the loom repaired, and all I have to do is reinstall it. It goes in the bottom hole here, not the speaker hole. In she goes. Got to feed it through the hole in the door over here. A little bit of wiggling and jiggling. This wire has to go behind. That's for the speakers. Once you've finished putting the loom in, a little bit of silicone spray won't hurt, trying to get that grommet over there in. Once you've got it all reconnected like that, make absolutely certain you get that push pin holder for the harness in here, and the other one up here, and the speaker connection right there. Otherwise, this is gonna foul inside the window moving up and down, and you'll have a hell of a problem. And you don't want that. So when you're finished working on a car, if you've done it right, nobody should be able to tell you even touched it. Except that it's working, of course. And one of the last things I like to do is just pop this out. It just turns out it's the power window switch. Just connect it and test this system to make sure the power door lock works, the power window works before you put it all back together. Always a good idea to test it before you go to all that trouble. Well, all systems go. Gonna work the door lock. Got a working window. Everything's good. So just remember, you've got two or possibly three other doors, and this is gonna happen at some point. They're made of exactly the same materials, and they have that same loom, same kind of thing. Just sell a truck. It's easier. Anyway, thanks for watching Car Questions, and please subscribe.